back to this channel. So for today's video, I'm gonna talk about the AI cloud. So AI cloud is a free cloud service provided by Asus. But before you're doing that, you must have an Asus router. And you don't have one, you have to buy one before doing this. And if you already have one, then in this video, I'm gonna tell you exactly what to do to have the AI cloud service. This tutorial will be a long video, so please be patient and see you in next clips. So before start, first you need to prepare a USB drive or SD card or hard drive with an adapter to USB. The best size would be 64GB and larger, because you need to store larger file and use it for a long time. Hi guys, so after all the preparation, first thing you need to do after is connect your drive to the PC, In this, I'm using the macOS as an example. So you open the drive. If there's anything in drive and if you need it, you must be safe with it in other place, because this drive will be reformatting and mounted, so those files would be lost. Or if you don't need it, you can just go straight to throw it into the bin. So hi guys, I'm come back. So now I'm gonna show you how to do this in the Windows. So in Windows, if you first click the yellow folder in the bottom, and you click this PC. In here, after that, you should see a drive. It got the name of your disk drive. In mine, it's the example drive. So click inside it. And if there's anything else you need to move it out. And if you don't need it, and you must delete it. And if there's nothing else, you can just close the folder. In the second step, first you need to plug the disk into the router. After that, you have to have a Windows PC. If you got a MacBook, that's fine, you can use the Windows in the bootcamps. So after all the things you have done, you only need one thing, is go to check the LAN address of your router. So first, you need to go to login into your router. So after you log in, you go to click the network map, and in here you will see the LAN IP. So this is the part you need to remember, because we need using it in the afterwards. So the first step you want to do is open your Telnet on your PC. So how to open that is you click on this button. Just follow my movements and type the control panel. Inside the control panel, make sure you find the the program. Click the program, and in here you need to click this button, turn Windows feature on or off. And inside this place, you need to find the Telnet. Telnet, so it should be here. So I'm already opened. Just click here, select it, and click OK. The next step, what you want to do is allow Telnet connection on your old routers. So for this stage, we need to go to your router's settings. So in here, type you need to type the username and the password here. So while you are inside, you are going to the administrations. In here, after that word, you click system. Swipe down and you will see here, this enable Telnet. So make sure you select yes and then you click apply. Okay, so that's how you enable the Telnet connection on your router.
So now you have to follow my step to use the Telnet connection to format and unmount the disk. So first you find terminal, type terminal and click enter. In here you type Telnet and the line address of your router. So in my case is 192.168.51.1. After type all this in, click enter. And here it asks you to use your login. So first you need the username. After that you type your password. Don't worry because the password in here doesn't show anything, but after you type all your password in, click enter. And it should be enter the system. So in here, the next step, first you need to check if your disk is properly connected to the router. So type fdisk minus l and type enter. Now you can see your disk. The formatting is have now is efit. It's a SDB 9. Remember, it's SDB 1. This is a number of your disk. Sometimes it could be SDA 1, but in here, in my case, it's SDB 1. So we just type. Now we need to access this drive. So we type have disk if SDB. Okay, just type like this. And click enter. In here you are now in the drive and you need to follow my step to formatting this drive. First type D and then type N. After that type P and type 1 and type 1. In here you see the number is 1884, so you need to type 1884. But so it might be different in other devices. After that, just click enter and in here you type W. So you just need to now what you need to do is unmount the disk. So unmount diff as the disk is SDB1. Make sure you didn't type wrong and click enter. So it's if it's in this case you don't need unmount because it's already fine. So then what you need to do is just type fkfs and dot x dot x3 slash and diff sdb1. So after you type it is functioning, click enter. So then you just wait to for the process to finish. Don't type anything yet. If you are in this step, it will be now it's in processing, so you don't type anything, just wait. So now it's finished. So now what you need to do is create a folder where you want to have your external drive mounted to. So I named my one should be share folder. It should be mkdir NT and none is your name share folder. So make a mistake. So after that, you just click enter. And then you need to make it so that the external drive can automatically mount each time the router reboots by doing the following. So just type vi space key slash etc and slash and fs tab. After you type all those things, click enter. Here you will enter this tab, and then what you need to do is first click the I key on your keyboard and type the click enter. And then what you need to do is in this case you need to type so you see here I already typed it, but in this case you need to type D, and because the num drive node is SBD1, so it should be SBD1, depends on the drive, and mount. Share folder, so it's a folder you created. X3, so that's the format. The format, so defaults. So in here, after you download, you just click the enter key and click the exit key. Then when you are in a new row, just type the following. After you type those, click enter to accept the VT text editor. In here, now what you need to do is in here you need a space, I forgot that thing. So space MNT and share folder. Okay, now it's done. So you can go to the next step to get your AI cloud working. Just close the terminal.
So hi guys, so now you are reaching the last step. So let's go to your browser and log into your router. So in here you can check in the network map. If it shows like this, it means your USB is successfully detected by the router. So now just click the AI Cloud 2.0. In here, when you're setting up AI Cloud, make sure you open the cloud disk and smart access. You need to open both of this. So after that, you just click the link and you should go to your AI cloud. And you are able to see the disk you plugged into your router. So this cloud service you can use whether in your home or your outside home. But only if you got the internet, then you can access all the videos or your files on this drive. And you can also you can also create a file. So look, you can create a folder, so AI for example YouTube channel, and yeah, here we are, and you can upload files or play video. Yeah, that's it. Okay, so thanks everyone who watched this video. And if you think this video do help you, please click the like button and subscribe to this channel. I would be very appreciated. And okay, that's it.